Every day is a very special day. Especially today, my birthday. So it's very important. Thank you, thank you. The cake is waiting. Don't wait too long, but it's... Hebrew, the real one, what do you mean? So, Be'ezrat Hashem, it's a good day for tefillot and for berachot. So I wish to each one of you berachah and etzlacha, v'chol ma'asei yadechem, parnasa tova, b'riut etana, long life, and all the best. Amen. So I will dedicate the shiur l'ilui nishmat, Devora Fege bat Shemuel. Ora Devora bat Shemuel, Esther Rivka bat Avraham, Monica, Miriam bat Fani, and Menachem Mendel ben Elchanan. I just wanted to clarify a little bit the halachot that we were mentioning inside. Rabotai, again, obviously there is a regular order of berachot. It's called Maga Esh. We're starting with Mezonot, then Agefen, then Aetz, then Adama, then Sheakol. That's a regular order of the regular berachot. Just the thing that I mentioned was that once you're starting the berachot of the fruits, Bore Peri Aetz, also over there you have to start with one beracha in particular. So let's say you have a very large table of different type of fruits, you're going to start to see if you have the following order. If you have first olives, so you're going to say the beracha of Bore Peri Aetz on olives. You don't have olives, you have something else, so depends. If you have grapes, or if you have dates are coming before the grapes. If you have dates, you're going to say Bore Peri Aetz on the dates. You don't have no olives and no dates, you're going to say Bore Peri Aetz on grapes. You don't have grapes, then you're going to go to figs. Figs is called Te'ena. Yeah? And then at the end, if you don't have anything, just a pomegranate, you're going to say on the pomegranate Bore Peri Aetz. That's the regular order, right? To see whatever you have on the table. That was the first halacha. The second halacha that I mentioned was that Be'ezrat Hashem, I believe you're going to have a very nice table for Tu Bishvat. Here in the shul, we're going to do a special event. Once you finish eating and drinking and everything was so good, so obviously it depends how much did you eat. If you just tasted a little bit, you're not going to say Berakha Haruna. But if you ate, you had kazayit, 27 grams of each. So you had kazayit mezonot, you had kazayit aetz, one of the seven fruits that I mentioned. You had kazayit agefen. Which beracha achrona you will have to say? Beracha achrona that will cover all of the three. Then I ask, what if I started my beracha achrona, right? And I skip by mistake, ala gefen ve'al peri agefen, I skipped. Or by mistake, I skipped ala aetz ve'al peri aetz. I said ala mechaya, but I skipped the other one. So the halakha writes that you will have to repeat one more time the beracha harona, but just for the beracha that you skipped. You're not going to say ala mechaya again if you already said it. But you will have to say again, ala aetz ve'al peri aetz, or ala gefen ve'al peri agefen. That was the halakha, just to have it clear before Tu Bishvat. Mezat Hashem, we're going to be talking. No, those halakhot really applies the whole year round. But Tu Bishvat is a day that mostly applies. Rabotai, I want to share with you. One of the points that I believe we have speak about many, many times. But it's very important to reinforce it. And especially in this point of view. You know, it's written that Moshe Rabbeinu is taking out Am Yisrael from Egypt. Correct? And when he's taking out Am Yisrael from Egypt, and Kriyat Yam Suf, where we're going to read this parashat, right? Parashat Shirat Hayam. Says the Pasuk, Vayaminu Ba'ashem of Moshe Avdo. Am Israel getting to the level of believing on Hashem and also believing on Moshe Rabbeinu. And the question is very obvious. Now you believe on Hashem and in Moshe? Before going out from Egypt, you didn't believe? The whole reason why you had the merit to go out from Egypt was because you trust and you believe on God. Only having the sheep next to the bed and having the Egyptians asking you, what are you doing with this sheep? And he said, what do you mean? We're going to do Shehaita. Shehaita is going to do to you, Habibi. It's my idol. And they didn't get confused because they had emunah. So what do you mean? Only at the moment of splitting of the sea, then vayaminu ba'Hashem Moshe Avdo, then they believe. And the answer is, Rabotai, Emunah, it's very nice and it's very easy to talk about it, and it's very hard to apply it. Emunah comes at the moment that more the person is in the challenge, more he shows how much Emunah does he have. You know what happened when they went out from Egypt? They went millions of people going out from a country. Right? We have seen in the past years people that had to leave their countries, you know, with all their family. What a headache. Imagine a whole nation leaving the country. They were coming out like today. You have a suitcase and you have cars and you have planes. Everything is by hand and carrying all type of bags and with the babies and with the little kids and mashallah, 6, 7, 8 kids, every family. And Rabotai, at the end of the day, after 3 days of walking and walking, they get finally into a dead end. That dead end is the water. And then they say, okay, let's take a right, let's take a left. They say, what right, what left? Look behind you. And they were coming with all the power, guns, all what you can imagine, to destroy Am Yisrael. And in that moment, say Moshe, say, HaKadosh Baruch Hu to Moshe, Ma titzak elai? What are you screaming to me? The better B'nai Yisrael, V'Yisau? Tell them to walk. To walk where exactly? Can you tell me where to walk? He said, what do you mean? In front of you. What do you mean in front of you? This is water. Walk. And in that moment, Ami said they were in the test of Emunah. Are you able to take out your common sense, your logic, calculation, and to do whatever God is asking from us? Or over here you think that you're smarter a little bit more, but because it doesn't make sense to walk in the water? And this is called Vayaminu Ba'Hashem of Moshe Avdo. Only then, when this guy, Nachshon ben Aminadav, threw himself inside the water, and he started to walk, no questions. Only in his merit, the water got split. And once they got split, they all understood. V'yaminu b'Hashem u'Moshe Avdo. Rabotai, this Yetziat Mitzrayim that we have in every single generation, every single one of us have moments of Yetziat Mitzrayim. Have moments that we're going to be in a dead end. We find no exits. And the only way to find an exit is at the moment that I trust that I'm not the one that is choosing. If you hold that you're the one that is choosing, Habibi, you're going to get stuck in that dead end. Take out your mind and go with Borei Olam. Let me tell you, I get this story much recently. There was a Yehudi that survived the Holocaust. This guy, Baruch Hashem, he had a long, long life. The grandsons of this man, they ask him, Grandpa, you know, we heard all what happened to you in the war. We heard all what you lose. We heard about your mother. We heard about your certain siblings that you had. Can you tell us how come that you still with a huge smile in your face every single day? How it's possible? And then the grandpa says, listen up. When the war started, we were living in, how do you call it? Vienna, I think it was. And they were living in Vienna. And one night, he said, no one told us anything. In the middle of the night, we heard somebody knocking on the door very strongly. And they didn't even wait for us to open up the door. They broke the door. They came in. There were at least 15 to 20 soldiers from that country, Vienna, Austria, right? Austria. Yeah. Vienna. And they took them, and they said, because we're having the Nazis coming in, we're taking whoever is coming first. to be part of the army. And they decided to take the father of this family. He said, "It's so hard for me to explain to you the drama. We were, mashallah, 8 kids in the family. All of us little kids. And all of a sudden, in the middle of the night, and we all woke up throughout the yells and the screams. And we see our mother screaming, 'Please don't take my husband.' And there's no one to talk with. They decided that they're going to take the husband and halas. And the husband said, 'Fine, I'm going with you guys. But 1 second, can you give me 1 minute? I just want to tell something to my family before I leave them. I don't know if I'm going to see them again.' And he comes to his wife and to his kids. And he said, 'Kids, do me one favor. I don't know what's going to be. We're already seeing what's going around. I just want to ask from you one thing to do. Whenever you're going to have something to choose, don't want to choose it. Let God to choose for you. Whatever situation will happen, don't want to take a decision already. Wait. But Olam is going to bring it to you, whatever you deserve.' They hug each one of the kids, they cried, and the father leave. Says this kid, he's not anymore a kid, until 120, Be'ezat Hashem. He said, 'Listen, we left, and next morning, we weren't the only one in the neighborhood that there is no father. There was a bunch of over 30 families, over 200 kids, no kids, no father. And they started to look, what are they supposed to do? My mom started to ask around, and they said, 'Listen, the only choice, the Nazis are coming. There is a sakana, a danger. The only thing that we can recommend you is 2 things. There are certain churches around the area. One thing is to leave the kids in the church. Second option, outside the city, there is a small towns that they have farmers, and there are some farmers that are ready to take kids to save them.' The mother decided that she's going to go to the farmers instead of the church. She gets there, and there were hundreds of kids waiting in line. Who's going to be the guy that will take them? Said the kid, all of a sudden there is a good-looking guy, looks very intelligent, very professional. Comes and he says, so who is ready to give me the kids? And there were a bunch of mothers coming into the guy, very nice guy, 'Please take my kids, please take my kids.' And he said, and I see my mother about to run, like all the mothers, to run to this guy and to tell him, 'Please take my kids.' She's about to leave, and then I grab her from the hand and I say, 'Mommy, come here 1 second. You remember what daddy said before he left? We don't choose. Mom, don't choose. If we're supposed to be by this goy, we're going to get by the goy.' And the goy came and he started to watch the kids and he started to take. He took 30 kids and he didn't take one of them. After a few minutes, there came another goy. This goy was looking terribly. Megusham, dirty guy. Not respectful. And he came and he asked again, 'Who wants to come with me?' Who wants to come with this guy? A few mothers, they gave their child. And the man started to go around and he said, 'You, you're going to come with me. You also, that's your brother, that's your sister, come.' And he took all of the family of this man. He said, 'The whole war, we survive by this goy. He feed us. He gave us what to dress. And that's it. At the end of the war, he throw us. Halas, go to the streets. I don't want to know about you anymore. And that's it.' After the war, he said, his mother passed away. They killed her. Some siblings as well. The father survived. And they went to see What happened to the 30 kids of the other men? Guys, this Rasha Merusha, at the end of the war, he keep up all the kids alive. Once the war ended, he came one day and he shoot down all of the 30. And they found all of these bodies dead. And then he came back to his father and he said, Daddy, whatever you recommend us, I trusted and I did it. And now he turns up to his grandkids and he says, you know why I still have the smile? Because all of those years from that moment and on, all my life, I had this concept of not choosing and letting Borei Olam to choose for me. Rabotai, sometimes this is the hardest emunah. We have to do ishtalud, we have to do an effort. But when it comes to a choice, you choose for it. Give to HaKadosh Baruch Hu also the options to choose for you, and you're going to see that if Borei Olam is going to choose for you, for sure it's going to be the best choice. Baruch Adonai Olam.